Money. Money has basically gotten many people where they are today. It contains power, persuasion, and a bloody history. If you possess just the right amount, you can get almost anyone to do whatever you'd like them to do. That is, if they're desperate or willing enough, which turns out to be the case a lot of the time. I want you to imagine, to think, right now. If I gave you $5,000 and asked you to go down Niagara Falls, would you? What would you be willing to do for $500,000? 5 million? I know I'd be listening. And that, right there, is money's overwhelming power over you, over me. It can influence you greatly, make you greedy, perhaps some people more than others. That some people are desperate enough to do things like go down Niagara Falls, or even deal drugs. After all, it's a quick, easy way to get money, wouldn't you agree? It influences the decisions you make day by day, week by week. What food to buy, what clothes to buy, what the cheapest item at what store is, even going so far as to impact the lifelong decision of your career. Money can twist your thoughts in a certain way. Let's take, for example, 1619, when the first African slaves were imported to America. From there, the numbers grew and grew, and cotton plantains were built and maintained by the slaves. I mean, why would you hire a bunch of workers when you can just force slaves to do it for you and save money while you're at it? Not only was there slavery, but also unspeakable acts of vicious cruelty done to the slaves if they misbehaved. It escalated even further from that horrible point, causing the American Civil War. The cause of this? Money. Let's say you did have $5,000. What would you buy? Would you treat yourself to a load of Starbucks? All the seasons of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air? A shopping spree? Or would you bring some friends along with you to eat out at a really fancy restaurant? Go on a trip. Buy them an exquisite gift. Just talking about it has me listing billions of options down in my head. But hold on, let me snap myself back to reality. Would any of you be doing or even thinking about the same things if you had, say, 50 bucks? I don't know about you guys, but that just cut down my list by a lot. Sure, there are still plenty of options, but not exactly the same things you probably had in mind when you had $5,000. What would you buy from Starbucks with $5,000 that's different from what you would buy if you had $50? Well, for starters, if I had $5,000, I'd buy the entire joint. Forget about a caramel cappuccino and a pastry. Now, are you starting to see how more or less money can change the decisions you make, whether based on want or need? As I decrease the hypothetical amount of money you hypothetically had, the amount of your hypothetical options started to decrease as well, even change. Money has a certain nonchalant way of building barriers around the things we decide, closing off certain options simply because they're too expensive. Well, what if you didn't need money to buy things or go places? Suddenly, the possibilities seem endless. We really should try to make as many decisions as possible without thinking about our financial state at the time. It's difficult to do because of the way we've allowed money to intertwine itself with our basic way of human living. Next time you're about to make a decision about something, think about how the amount of money you have is influencing that decision, and if it would be any different if money was no object.